Alright, I know I say this a lot, but I have to say, this chord progression is just awesome. It refers back to the Baroque period, referring to the lament bass pattern in a traditional passacaglia. And in essence, what it is a progression that's characterized by chromatic motion moving in opposite directions. So here's an example of that. Okay, if we simply look at what the word omnibus means, it's the Latin for all. We see it in lots of contexts. For example, transportation, the word bus is an abbreviation of the word. We also hear it in reference to literature when we're talking about a collection of stories either by a particular author or a collection of articles maybe around a single subject, and we even see it in relationship to bills that are being submitted for legislation. So for music, it's relating to that chromatic motion found in the bass line. Oftentimes we're seeing it descend because of its roots. However, you also can see it ascend. Now, basically we use this because it allows a composer to either extend a dominant function or smoothly modulate away from the tonic, or some combination thereof, and the latter obviously being really interesting to us this semester. But as I've already implied, this progression has been around for a long time, and there's an article posted in this module where I'm pulling our musical examples from by Paula Telesco. She does a great job of really explaining and outlining the history of this chord, including the Passacaglia baseline and how composers basically exploit the richness of the chromaticism, which is just brilliant. We also see how it kind of morphs through time and moves away from our typical tonic or obscures it. So this video essentially outlines a lot of the article's findings, and starting with the music from before what we'll analyze, giving us the tools to analyze thereafter. She describes it as, quote, in its simplest class form, the omnibus is a 5-chord long and prolongs a dominant seventh via a chromatically filled in voice exchange involving scale degrees 5 and 7. So we're gonna check out basically this chord progression as seen here, this example number 2. And what becomes really interesting is the second chord, where we could either analyze it as a 5-7 of 3 or as a German of 2, and here we see, oh, well, it resolves just as a German ought to, but then it's outlined by yet another German of 2, and then using that to get to the 5-7. So it's really, really cool. But what we really interested in is actually the voice exchange between the soprano and the bass line between that 5 and 7. So just so you kind of have this in your ear, I'm gonna try to play this here. So again, starting with that 5-6-5, where you've got the T, T and small in your outer voices alone, you see how they outline. And then, okay. The next example Actually, it's just really lovely. It's the Schubert Piano Sonata in A minor, which I know I say this all the time, but I mean it. Go do yourself a favor, go listen to it. It's just awesome. So you figure that this is also really close to the period of music that we're interested in. It was composed in 1825. And what is really nice is how Schubert provides us the lovely gift of establishing that scene. And then before actually manipulating these chords, he kind of just repeats over and over, I'm doing something, I'm going to do something, and then go ahead and gives us the omnibus chords. So this excerpt is something like. Drive of, well, I'm gonna keep playing these chords over and over until they decide, oh, I've misspelled it, so I'm gonna spell it correctly so it's the German two, and then progress forward. Telesco then compares a traditional Passacaglia realization with an omnibus progression, so we can plainly see how this was evolving, which I think is just really nice. So you're going to see that both progressions are using a dominant prolongation manifested through this voice exchange. Both progressions are built. The chords built on the lowered seventh and sixth scale degrees are the dominant seven sonorities. In the Passacaglia, two different dominant sevens are used. We have the 5-4-2 of four, and then we've got the augmented German six. While in the Omnibus, the same dominant seventh chord is used each time, just in a different inversion. So we get that German of two again, that motion, which is really common, I'm finding at least. And in each of the progressions, the chord is built on the raised sixth scale degree. It's essentially the same chord, but it's a matter of if we're gonna have the 4-6 or if we're gonna have the 2-6-4. And then these are diatonic passing chords used between the 5-6-5 and the 5-7. The Passacaglia tonicizes the 4, while the Omnibus kind of tonicizes 2 nested within the dominant prolongation. And then each one using the German going as you're supposed to the 1-6-4 and then the 5. So here is their example of the Passacaglia. As opposed to the omnibus, same bass line, same voice exchange, they as such. And really, in that omnibus, you can really hear that chromaticism. Going in contrary motion, as opposed to the Passacaglia, which just kind of walks up a scale, does add a little play, a playful character, but is not as chromatic, right? That certainly is chromatic, but there's first. right? Not being so much. And so that kind of gives us that. Now, what I really love about this article is that she ends it, or semi ends it, with a fully realized omnibus progression. So basically, we're weaving between several tonal centers, and then easing us back into that 5-7. So she starts off with this 5-6-5 of C and ends with a 5-7 of C. And so here is an attempt at playing that, and you can follow along as well. Really, really brilliant stuff, huh? So we see the composers of the 19th century exploiting this progression already because it's already familiar to our listeners. And what we'll see in our analysis is that we're manipulating the ambiguity, the ambiguous tonal possibilities, in order to remove to remote, more remote enharmonic possibilities. I hope you enjoy, and you can play around with these progressions, and you can kind of come up with your own variations of them, which is really cool. Okay, ciao.